even after I got to know much more about her in terms of the suffering, in terms of the suffering. But I also thought about a story that I've told at funerals before, which I think is very important for us. You see, it was the old woman who walked around town and always had her Bible under her arm. And that's all she ever had under her arm was the Bible. Finally, one day, a young man went up to her and said, "Oh, lady, what is it about you? You carry that Bible around all the time. Don't you read anything else? Don't you read any novels? Don't you read any love stories? Don't you read anything other than that?" She looked at him and said, "Son, I can't read any other book, but this is the only book that reads me." And I say that because I believe we who say you are followers of Jesus Christ, if we're true to that calling and we live that out, we should be able to open up the Bible. And as we read those scripture stories, our names should jump off the page. Now, if it's not, and you say, "Oh, no, there's nothing in the Bible about me," you better be taking a little self-inventory. You better be checking it out. And that's why there are many, many gospel passages that I could have chosen to condemn today that would have so good to her life. The Beatitudes, the five wise, the five foolish virgins, she would have been among the wise.
Yes.
You know, there's so many gospel passages, but I settled on this gospel passage today because I think it speaks to the reality of her life. You see, whenever I hear the gospel that says, "Take my yoke upon you," I think of a heavy burden. I think of great pain. And yet, when we look at what a yoke actually does, it forces the two oxen to walk together. And when the two oxen are walking together, pulling that plow or whatever that implement is that they're pulling, it makes it easy. Death took the yoke of Jesus Christ upon her shoulders because she walked with Jesus. You know, Death is right there in that pew on Sunday. I always had a smile on my face. You could always tell she was really into what was going on here in the Word and in the Eucharist. You always knew that. Because of the smile on her face, because her eyes being closed, because her head being raised to God.
Yes.
And she was a willing servant of Jesus Christ. And as that willing servant of Jesus Christ, she was willing to take upon herself that which Christ placed upon her.
Yes.
And some of what he placed upon her was a great burden of pain and suffering and death. But death bore that. Even in the midst of pain and suffering, I remember how she would come in on some of those Sundays after teaching religious education class, knowing that that was not easy for her to be there. And we're high school students, first of all. I think her daughter was one of them. That should explain a whole lot of things. But, you know, to be and to keep them engaged and to keep them going in the midst of pain and suffering was not easy. I know with the Curtis and the Curtis, Shirley, you know at home, in the midst of pain and suffering, she still did many, 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 many things for you that took a lot of effort and a lot of energy. But she took that upon, carried that cross of suffering love. Because Davenport also knew something else. She knew that the cross led to the resurrection. Joy of resurrection. But the wonderful thing about Deb, I think, that really tempered and brought life to that suffering was that she did it all because she knew Jesus.
Yes.
Because she was walking with Jesus. She knew his gentle. I didn't say one good one. That's all I have. But in the midst of all that, being a good sister-in-law and friend to so many people, especially right here in this church. And all of it was done because of a gentle, humble heart. And I think even if Deb was alive, and I was to say to her, Deb, could you go and do it all over again? I'm sure she'd say, yeah. Because she also understood that what was placed upon her and those people who were placed in her life was placed there because that's who God wanted there. You know, and so you live with that, you work with that. But we always do it with love. So today, as we gather, we celebrate a woman of faith. We celebrate a woman of love. With three most important things in her life was faith, family, and church. We thank God for the gift of Deb Davenport. We thank God for the many ways that He revealed His love for us through her care, through her concern, through her serving, through her cooking gumbo. Deb sleep in peace. May she know the love of Jesus who first loved her. May she be that angel who's looking down on us, because we know that even in death, Deb will continue to love. Let us stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where He intercedes for His church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to His. In baptism, Deborah received the light of Christ, scattered the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Our sister Deborah was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us in the way of the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The family and friends of Deborah seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Deborah. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord God, give her peace and heal her souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Deborah may be taken up into glory with your Son. In his great mystery of love, we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. But through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to the setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord.